Jesus，
现在就要将一切的荣耀跟赞美都归给他。
你刚的全，你那个要反应啊。That has nothing to do with Jesus, by the way. I don't know where I got that from. Anyways, hey, hey, hey. 转向你旁边的人，给他一个拥抱。
Turn to your neighbors and give them a hug.
你知道我们刚刚？哎 ，Why am I speaking Chinese now? I'm sorry. I'll speak Chinese. You know what? 你知道我们刚刚唱的这首歌
？The song we just sang.
The song that we just sang.
Yeah, 我们刚刚唱这首歌。
The song that we just sang.
我们刚刚唱这首歌。
It's talking about building your life upon the rock that is Jesus Christ.
将大把你的生命建造在耶稣基督这块磐石上。
And we know from the Bible, it teaches us to do that.
圣经也教导我们要这么做。
The Bible says if you are wise,
他说如果你够聪明
and not foolish,
如果你有智慧不是愚蠢的
how many of you are wise in this place?
我们当中多少人是有智慧的举手我看一下
Amen.
Amen.
You will learn to build your life upon the rock.
你就会知道你要把你的生命建造在磐石上
You know, two weeks ago,
你知道两个礼拜前
I was in Canada,
我在加拿大
and jet lag 5:00 a.m. in the morning I woke up.
那个时候时差所以五点钟清晨五点我就
醒 and I was watching this TV show talking about houses.
然后我就是看到一个介绍建造房屋的电视
and there was this house in Vancouver. The guy who built it, he built it upon the rock.
那个电视节目就介绍说，在温哥华有些人把自己的房屋建造在磐石上。
So I'm watching the show.
我就在看那个节目啊。
I thought to myself.
然后想说
，What a wise builder!
哇，这个人真的好聪明啊。
He must have read the Bible.
他一定有读过圣经，知道该在哪。
And yet, for the next 30 minutes of the program,
可是你知道我看到后面那30分钟里呢
？The contractor keep on telling the guy, because you built your house on the rock, your house actually has many issues.
那个建造的工头就说：“哎，你知道你这个房子就是会盖在牌子上，所以好多的问题。
It has a lot of water leakage.
就是有漏水的问题啦。
And I was watching this.
然后我就看。
And I felt like God was teaching me a lesson.
我一边看，我就一边觉得神在教导我功课。
God was trying to tell me something.
神在告诉我说
，Just because you built the house on the rock,
是因为你把房子建造在磐石上
，It doesn't mean there won't be issues that come into your life.
不代表你的生命不会面临到任何的问题。
It just means your house is stable and secure on the rock.
你的房屋会够稳固，因为它在一个磐石上。
It just means no matter what issues you may face,
意思是不论你遇到什么样的困难
，It's still going to be standing there on the rock.
它还是会坚立在那块磐石上。
Where you come from?
你从哪里来
？What kind of issues you carry?
你生命里面带着什么样的问题
？We invite you today.
我们今天邀请你。
Build your house on the rock.
把你的房子建造在这块磐石上。
Your life on the rock.
把你的生命建造在这块磐石上。
And it's okay to have some issues, right?
有问题也是没有关系的。
Amen. So if you have issues, hug your neighbor.
所以你生命里面有问题，赶快给旁边一个拥抱，让他知道。
我们生命中都有一些问题。
Yeah, we all have problems in our life.
We all have some issues.
就是都有一些问题。
All right. Grab a seat, grab a seat, grab a seat.
大家请坐，请坐。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Wow. Man, man, we've been having such a great last few days.
我们过去这几天真的很蒙福。
And the reason why I've been having such a great few days is because Pastor Steve Dixon and his wife Joyce has been with us the last few days.
为什么这么蒙福呢？因为 Pastor Steve Dixon 跟他的太太 Joyce 在我们的当中。
Now, if you are not familiar with who they are,
那如果你不认识他们
，you need to know they are part of this family.
你们可能不知道，其实他们一直都跟我们走在一起。
You know, for the last 3-4 years,
过去这三十年
，I've gotten to know Pastor Steve and his wife.
我认识了 Pastor Steve 跟他太太。
Joyce and they've been such a wonderful blessing to myself and this church.
他跟他太太 Joyce 真是我们自己跟我生命里面很大的祝福。
Last year when we were planning to plant the hope.
去年当我们开始在预备的 hope 的职堂工作。
Pastor Steve gave Pastor John and I so much advice and so much wisdom.
Pastor Steve 真的传授给我还有 Pastor John 我们很多的智慧。
And so for the last few years, I just want you to know.Whatever wise decisions I've made in the past,
所以我要你们知道的是，过去这几年来，如果你们有觉得我哪一些决定做得非常的有智慧
，It's probably because of Pastor Steve or Pastor John. It's because of these two people.
就是 Pastor John 或者是 Pastor Steve 这两个人给我讲。
The Bible says if you walk with the wise, you become wise.
圣经里面说，你与有智慧人同行，你也就会得到智慧。
This is why it's so important for us.
所以我们呢，真的非常的重要，要知道。
Because we are only a church that's 6 months old.
因为我们现在才六个月大，对吗？我们的教会。
Imagine, oh no, 7 months now.
这现在已经七个月，第七个月。
Man, I feel old now. 7
7 months old。
我现在觉得长好大了，七个月大的孩子。
For 7 months old。
我们现在是七个月大的教会。
It means we need a lot of wisdom。
意思我们真的需要很多智慧在。
That's why we need to walk with those who have wisdom。
这是为什么我们需要与有智慧的人同行。
And this is why we're so thankful that Pastor Steve can be here。
这也是我们非常的感谢 Pastor Steve， 他可以挪出时间来到我们。
He and his wife Pastor， they're in charge of 10 campuses， Hillsong campus in Australia。
Pastor Steve 跟他太太，他们还有其他的牧师在澳洲是负责牧养时间的不同分堂。
And under his care， there are over 10,000 people。
然后呢，总共有将近10,000人在他们牧养底下。
That his leadership directly impacts。
然后是他直接可以牧养跟带领的人。
And so he's been such a blessing to us。
对，他真的是大大的祝福了我们。
And so today，
所以今天
，the hope。
The hope 的弟兄姐妹，
can we welcome not a guest but a person who is part of this family?
我们邀请的不是一个客座讲员，我们是邀请我们的家人回来，我们跟。
Can we stand up from our seat?
我们从位置上面站起来。
Let's welcome Pastor Steve to come out.
来到台上。
To bring the word of God today.
带下神的话语到我们当中。
Wonderful. 你好 ，How are you? How are you? How are you?
你好吗？大家好吗？
Thank you.
谢谢。
Well, what a great welcome.
真的是很热情的欢迎。
We have been so blessed, shown so much hospitality for the last 3 days.
我们过去这三天真的是经历到台湾人大大的热情的招待。
Most of the hospitality starts on a dish and goes into my mouth.
通常招待的方式就从桌上的一道道菜里面，然后进到我的身体。
Taiwan。You must eat more food than anybody I know in the
world. 我真的觉得，就是台湾人一定吃的比所有世界上其他国家人都还多。
When I arrived on Thursday morning, I looked like a noodle.
我礼拜四来的时候，我是竹竿人。
I weighed exactly the same as Adriana.
就是跟小芝传道一样，就是跟他差不多瘦小。
But now I feel like a lasagna.
但是你看，才不过三天就长了这么多，大了这么多。
Spicy beef cow, not the noodle.
吃了不少。
All because of the hospitality.
真的是谢谢你们的热情招待。
Listen, greetings to you from everybody in Hillsong Church World.
我们是从 Hillsong 带来我们家人的热招待祝福来。
So many of our people know you, are aware of you, pray for you.
所以呢，你要知道，不论在世界哪里，都在为你祷告。
In Queensland, Pastor Peter and the team have been over there and spent time with us many times.
然后呢，Pastor Peter 他们也会在Queensland 到的时候会花些时间跟我们在那里。
And we love you very, very, very much.
我们真的非常爱你。
And I can promise you this.
我可以跟你保证
we're not only interested in you and praying for you because I get the chance to be here. We will always be your friends.
我们不是只是因为今天你们邀请我来到这里讲道，我才为你们祷告。你们要知道，我们是时时刻刻不断为你们代祷。
And Joyce and myself, Joyce, my wife.
我的太太 Joyce.
Yeah. she's Chinese Malaysian.
So
She's a real Asian.
马来西亚裔的华人，所以她是真货真价实的华人。
I'm a pretend Asian.
我的是华人的心啊，华人的心。
But I eat Asian.
所以我吃亚洲人的食物吃得非常
顺。And that's the most important thing.
这是最重要的。
I reckon.
很合亚洲的胃口。
They call me the egg.
他们称我为就是外白内黄。
White on the outside and yellow on the inside.
外白内黄的蛋。
Wonderful. Before we start, I'd also like you to know this.
那在坐下之前，我还是要你们知道一件事。
That I am no longer 21 years of age.
就是我现在已经就看出来嘛，不是只有21岁。
I have just entered my 6th decade in life.
我刚进入我生命的第六十。
And I've seen many churches.
那我相信的许多教会。
And many church pastors and leaders.
那许多教会的牧者。
And I just need you to know.
也需要你们知道。
That you have great pastors and great leaders.
就是你们的教会的牧者领袖团队是非常优秀的。
And Pastor Peter and Pastor Peggy are people not only of great ability but great integrity.
我相信 Pastor Peter 跟 Peggy 他们不光是有良好的领导才干，他们也是非常纯全的正直的。
And we trust them.
我们是非常的信靠他们。
It's been our honor to get to know them.
是我们的荣幸能够认识他们两位。
And you are in good hands.
然后呢，你们是在很棒的领导团队底下。
So I think you should thank Jesus.
所以你们应该要将一切掌声都归给荣耀耶稣，为着你的领袖献上感谢。大家请坐。
Wonderful.Is everybody happy?
大家都还开心吗？
That's good.
很棒，很棒。
I already love this church.
我一来就觉得超爱这间教会。
We talked about it and prayed about it before you started your first services.
因为你们还没有开始第一堂主日崇拜的时候，我们就已经在澳洲不断为你们祷告。
And to see you 6 months after the first weekend service is a beautiful thing to see.
然后呢，看到你们从开堂到现在已经六个月了，甚至已经到进入七个月，你们还在这里。
But you do realize you are a baby of 6 months.
但是你们还知道自己也不过才半岁大嘛，对不对？还是个小婴孩。
Imagine when you get older.
你想象，等到有一天你长大了。
Imagine when you become that cheeky little 2 years of age.
你想象你变到那个两三岁，就是我们说很恶魔的那个时候。
Imagine when you are a young adult.
就想象你成了一个社青。
Imagine what the Lord can do in Taipei.
然后呢
？From Taipei.
想象你长大以后，神可以怎么样大大使用你在台北，然后从台北做许多大事。
With a church that stays humble.
但是呢，你会是一个持续谦卑的教会，持续往前走。
Keep learning, keep growing.
持续学习成长的教会。
Keep learning new things.
不断在学习新事的教会。
Keep doing new things.
一直在做新事的教会。
Having new experiences.
然后呢，新的经历的教会。
If you're going to be part of this church, you will be on a great journey.
如果你就是持守在这间教会里面，我相信你会走在一段美好的道路上。
I would love it if every single person in this room today.
我很希望我们在座的每一个人
had opportunity to consider.
都能够有个机会来想一想。
Not only whether you are a believer in Jesus Christ.
不论你今天你是不是一个基督徒。
But also whether you can belong to a family that is on a good journey.
也想想看你是不是能够归属在一个大家庭当中，然后走在一条美好的道路上。
Most human beings want to be loved.
我说，不论你是不是有在想这些，每一个人都想要被爱。
Most human beings want to belong somewhere.
每一个人都希望自己能够归属在一个群体。
Even if it's to have a spouse and their own children.
就算你可能是有孩子有配偶的。
To feel a sense of home and a sense of family.
你也都渴望你是能够在一个家庭当中有归属感。
But usually we want to belong wider.
可是很。我们通常也不希望只是归属在一个小团体，而是能够有个更大的归属。
We want to belong to a bigger family or a bigger community.
归属在一个更大的家庭跟群体当中。
A human being wants and needs friendship.
因为每一个人都需要有朋友，有友谊。
We were made for relationship.
我们受造就是要在一个关系里的。
None of us choose to stay in one room on our own for the whole of our lives.
没有一个人是想要一生孤老，然后只有自己一个人在这个角落当中。
Isolation is a terrible thing.
你知道被孤立那是被孤立那是。是一个很可怕的事。
Friendship, relationship, community is a good thing.
我们总是渴望能够有友谊，有跟人的人际关系，这是一件好事。
Let me talk to you about belonging.
那我今天就想要来跟大家分享归属感。
Let me start with a story.
那我从一个故事开始讲起。
I have a cousin.
你知道我有个表哥。
I led him to the Lord just the night that I became a believer.
那其实是我自己信主之前，我带他也信主。
And he got married.
然后后来他结婚。
They couldn't have children, but they adopted 2 children.
他们没有办法生出孩子，后来他们领养两个小孩。
I'm very proud of them for that.
我非常的以此为引他为荣。
And how many of you know that to adopt a child is a big challenge?
可是如果你不知道的话，我跟你讲，领养小孩的过程很辛苦的。
It's a challenge not just for the 2 parents.
不是只是对父母来说这个过程很辛苦。
But it's a challenge for the child.
对孩子来说，被领养他也是很难接受的。
They adopted 2 children.
那他们是一次领养两个孩子。
Brother and a sister.
那这个两个孩子本来就是兄妹。
Who had a very traumatic birth.
那他们的自己的背景，身家背景非常惨。
And early season of life as babies.
在他们还小年幼的时候就经历
了难过事。
他们是被遗弃的。
The authorities took them.
然后是后来被社会局发现了他们。
After being fostered in different places, eventually my cousins adopted them.
然后呢，不断的送到不同的寄养家庭，最后是由我的表哥他们家领养他们。
And my cousins, they loved these children.
那你要知道，我的表哥真的非常的爱这两个孩子。
They gave them their name.
基本上还帮他们取名字。
They did everything for them.
然后呢，一切就是为了他们在做。
There was no thinking they're not really our children. They embraced them as their own children.
从来没有一刻想说这个两个孩子不是我亲生，而是把他们当自己的孩子。
The same excitement.
只要就是那样的兴奋之情。
The same love.
那样子的爱在爱他们。
But it's one thing to give love.
可是你知道，给予爱是一回事。
It's another thing for those children to return that love.
那个孩子接受了爱以后要回报，这又是另外一回事了。
And one of the children did much better than the other.
那这两个孩子当中，其中一个接受的很好，但另外一个。
The little girl grew up.
那这个女孩长大了。
Loving them as mum and dad.
同样就爱着我的表哥跟他的太太，就像他们的亲生父母。
Feeling loved.
然后呢，也感觉自己是被爱的。
And giving love back.
然后所以他可以给出爱给他们。
But the boy just couldn't do it.
但是呢，另外那个男孩子就没有办法。
He got into so much trouble.
然后呢，他一生经历极大的痛苦。
He used to steal from them.
他甚至从他们家里面一天到晚偷东西。
And sell things and use the money for beer or for drugs.
偷了东西以后把它变卖，然后就买拿去买酒或者买毒品。
And eventually he ran away.
然后最后他直接逃家。
And they had problems with the police.
所以呢，就常常被警察找。
They found him in other countries.
然后呢，后来又在别的国家发现他。
He ended up spending time inside institutions.
所以这个孩子很常进监护所。
What's the difference?
那你就说这两个孩子到底有什么差别？
the love they gave was exactly the same.
因为他们给两个孩子爱是完全一样的。
But it's only when you reciprocate that love.
可是唯有你当你能够回报回馈那样的爱。
Do you actually end up belonging to that family?
那才是真正知道自己归属在这个家的关系。
That is what the Lord has done for you and me.
而这也就是主为你和我所做的。
He's loved us with all of His heart.
他是全心的爱着我们每一个人。
He sacrificed. He's given us everything.
他甚至牺牲自己一切全所有，就是要给我们。
He's giving us His name.
他把他的名字给了我们。
But for this to work,
可是要让这件事情能够行得通，
we have to love back.
我们必须要回馈他的爱，
and see him as our father,
然后呢看他如同我们的天父，
and accept the love that he gives,
接受他所给我们的爱，
and then we belong to that family of God.
如此我们才能够真正归属在神的家中。
Church is just the same.
教会也是如此，不是吗？
When I was a young man, I went to church for the first time when I was 11 years of age.
你知道我很年轻的时候，我11岁第一次踏进教会，
and I didn't like it at all.
那时候我一点都不喜欢教会。
The church experience that I experienced that day,
因为你知道我那天经历到的教会呢，
was just so far away from where I was.
真的跟我这个人或者跟我的背景完全天差地远。
I saw priests with long dresses.
因为你知道那个时候的就是牧师他们还穿长袍，
swinging smoke around.
然后会撒那个香坛，就是香炉在那边挥。
I'm thinking, what are you doing?
然后我想说你们在干嘛？
And I just wanted to be outside playing football.
然后我就觉得坐不住，我一天到晚就想要出去打踢足球。因为我很喜欢运动。
And I just saw such a gap between me and church, and I could never belong to
that. 我就觉得教会跟我的实在差太多，我根本融不进这个地方。
I come into this church today.
但是今天我来到这个教会。
And I step into a nightclub.
我就发现，我是走进夜店。
My father was the manager of a nightclub.
你知道我的爸爸其实是一个夜店的经理哦。
In Manchester, England.
是在英国的曼彻斯特。
His dream for me was to be the manager of a to work in a nightclub.
他对他的孩子，也就是我的梦想，就是有一天我可以跟他一起在夜店工作。
At least I fulfilled the dreams of my father.
我走进来的时候，我完成我爸爸的梦想了。
But I come in here and the worship is vibrant and is alive.
可是我就发现我走进来这里的敬拜实在太有生命了。
The worship leaders mean what they sing.
然后呢，我也发现主里每一个他们是从心里面唱出这些歌词。
Adriana gets up here and bounces around with life in her body.
然后 Pastor Adriana 在台上就带奉献，也是带的好有力量。
Everything about it is different than the experience I had when I was a young boy.
我就发现在这间教会里面，我所经历到的一切都跟我还年轻的时候的教会不一样。
God is no different.
我说。但是神是不变的那
位。Jesus is no different.
耶稣也从来没有改变过。
The gospel is no different.
福音也没有改变过。
But the way that we do church has to be different.
只是我们经营教会的方式必须要有所不同。
Otherwise, I would come today with a long dress and a
lot of smoke. 我今天你想象我站在台上，我还拿着香炉，然后穿着长袍在那边挥的话。
And you would all go home and say, "I will never go back to the Hope Church ever again."
你们应该，我都还没有听到这里，就已经回家了，都不知道去到哪一间教会去了。
Let me talk to you about a man who would never imagine himself as belonging to the house of God.
这个人也从来没有想过自己居然可以融入的进神的家中。
It's a story of a man called Saul.
这个人呢叫做扫罗。
Later on in the Bible, he becomes known as Paul.
扫罗一开始是叫扫罗，后来他改名叫保罗。
But the first time his name is mentioned in the Bible,
可是呢，圣经里面第一次听到这个人的名字
is in chapter 8 of the book of Acts.
是在《使徒行传》第八章里。
And he was supporting the killing of a believer.
而那个时候的扫罗呢，他是完全支持要杀掉基督徒的。
See, his job was he worked for the Roman Empire.
他当时呢是为罗马政府在工作。
He worked for the emperor.
他是为罗马帝国在工作。
And they wanted to get rid of anybody who was a danger to the empire.
然后呢，当时罗马帝国就是要除灭一切会危害到帝国的人。
They just wanted everybody to bow the knee to the emperor.
他们基本上就是要所有的人向凯撒下跪。
And so they were very worried about Jesus and the Jesus followers.
所以他们一听到这个耶稣跟他的跟随者，他们就吓得心惊肉跳。
So his job.
那这个保罗扫罗工作，他的任务
was to get rid of the believers.
就是要把所有的基督徒都杀光。
In chapter 8 verse 1.
然后呢，在第八章第一节，就是第一次提到扫罗的名字。我们来看他怎么读。
Saul approved their killing of a believer.
这里讲到说，斯提凡被害，扫罗也欣然同意。
Then go to chapter 9 verse 1.
然后呢，接下来我们要看到使徒行传第九章。
And he's now threatening the believers.
第一节他还威胁基督徒。
Read the verse 2.
他就说，扫罗仍向主的门徒发恐吓凶杀的话。他到大祭司那里要求他发公函给大马士革各会堂，如果发现奉行这道的人，准他连男带女弃拿到耶路撒冷。
So he found people who belonged
to the way.
他就发现哪一些在奉行这道。
And his job was to imprison them.
也或者是说，他是归属在这个基督徒团体里面。
And he'd already agreed to the killing of a believer.
他就是要把他们下到监牢里面，然后只要愿意，他可以杀了他们。
So if he came to church at the Hope this morning,
所以你想象他今天来到了 Hope 这个地方
，you wouldn't be choosing to sit next to him.
你绝对不会想要坐在这个扫罗旁边。
You think let somebody else sit next to him.
就是别人可以坐，但我不要坐在他旁边。
Security guards, please.
这个人就坐他这边。
Keep your eye on him, please.
就是我们保全，可不可以看盯紧这个人
？Now let me read chapter 13 of the book of Acts.
让我们来读《使徒行传》第十三章。
From chapter 9 to chapter 13, just four chapters later.
你可以说从第九章到我们现在要读的十三章，也不过四章后。
Now read the first verse of that.
我们来看这里的第一二节怎么说。安提阿教会中有几位先知和教师，就是巴拿巴名叫尼杰的西面，古利奈人路求与分封王希律一同长大的马念和扫罗，他们侍奉主并且进食的时候，圣灵说要为我把巴拿巴和扫罗分别出来，去做我呼召他们做的工。
They're writing about the church in Antioch.
这里呢，他在描写的是安提阿教会。
And they write about the five leaders in the church.
然后呢，也讲到了这里的五位牧者或者是领袖。
And the fifth one is who?
那第五位你们看到是谁呀？
The same man, Saul.
就是我们刚刚前面念到的扫罗哎。
And everything I've already told you about him is true.
然后呢，我刚刚前面讲的都是真的，没有半句虚假。
But something has happened.
可是不知道发生什么事。
That he's now.One of the leaders in the very church that he was trying to kill people.
现在到了第十三节，原本他要杀光这些基督徒当中，他居然成了他们的领袖。
How did that happen?
你说怎么发生的？
Go to Acts chapter 20.
那我们要来看第二十章，使徒行传二十章。
This is probably a few short years later.
这可能又过了几年之后。
And this is what it says in verse 36, 7, and 8.
然后从第三十六节到第三十八节这里说，他说了这些话，就跪下来同大家一起祷告。众人都痛哭，抱着保罗与他亲吻。他们最伤心的是保罗说他们不会再见他的面那句话。于是最后他们送他上了船。
How did this happen?
你说怎么又演到这里的这个剧情
？He saw people who belonged to a community of believers.
他看到这些人，就是我们看到他们就是归属在这个信徒群体中。
He persecuted them.
这是原本他逼迫的那群人。
He chased them.
他一直追着这些人。
He imprisoned them.
然后还把他们下到监牢里。
He endorsed the killing of one of them.
甚至直接要去杀了他们的这些人。
How does somebody like that end up not only in the believers' community but a leader?
这个原本在逼迫杀害基督徒的人，不光是现在在他们当中，还成了他们的领袖，然后现在演成这样。
And how does it happen?
你说这怎么发生的？
The church loves him so much.
就是教会居然爱他爱到一个地步。
In Ephesus,
在以弗所这个地方
，where he had helped start this Christian community,
是他帮助建立起的这个基督徒的群体。
They loved him so much they cried when he was leaving.
这些基督徒爱他爱到一个地步，他要走了，不会再回来，他们都哭了。
He spent time with them.
他花时间跟他们在一起。
He was getting on a ship to leave.
然后他准备要上船了。
And he said, "You may not see me again."
就说你们可能不会再见我了。
And they all broke down in tears.
然后呢，双方都哭了。
Because they loved him so much.
因为那边的人实在是太爱他了。
But it's the same man.Who was persecuting them a few years before?
这人不就是几年之前逼迫的这群人的人吗？
So maybe you don't feel like you belong today.
所以可能今天坐在底下，你不觉得你归属这个地方？
Maybe you think I can't imagine myself being a Christian.
可能你想说，我根本想不到我自己有一天会成为基督徒。
Maybe you think, well, I like.Jesus,
他说啊，我喜欢耶稣。
But I'm not sure I belong in this church.
可是我不觉得我归属在这间教会。
Maybe you're new to Taiwan.
也或者你刚来到台湾。
Maybe you've just moved to Taipei.
也或者是你刚搬到台北。
Maybe you've had a bad experience in a church before, so you're not sure whether you want to belong.
过去你曾经去过别间教会，经验不是太好，所以你不确定自己想不想要归属在这里。
Or maybe you think you're too bad.
也或者你觉得我这人太糟了。
I need to be a better person before I belong to this church.
我如果想要归属在这里，我应该要先成为一个更好的人吧。
Did Paul?
保罗有，所以我就觉得这个扫罗有吗
？Because what happened to him was this.
因为你要知道发生在他身上是什么事。
In Acts chapter 9,
在第九章，使徒行传第九章。
The very same chapter.
就是我们刚刚读到那节经文。
That tells us that he was breathing out murderous threats against the believers.
讲到是他开口就是要去威胁，然后凶杀他们的话。
With that anger in his heart.
你要想象他是心里面带着这样的愤怒。
And hatred in his heart.
恨所有的基督徒。
He was on a road to Damascus.
然后呢，准备要去大马士革路上。
To persecute the believers.
去干嘛？去逼
迫其他基督徒。
And the risen Christ appeared to him.
然后呢，在那路上的时候，耶稣向他显明自己。
Isn't it amazing that Jesus chooses the one who thinks he's the worst?
你不觉得很有趣的是，耶稣拣选就是那个觉得自己是最糟糕的那个人向他显明。
Jesus didn't pick the best, the nicest people.
耶稣没有选那个最好或者表现最棒的人。
He appeared to Saul.
他是向自己显明给保罗、扫罗看。
And Jesus says, "Paul, Paul, why are you persecuting me?"
然后呢，耶稣说，保罗，保罗，你为什么要逼迫我？
And they have this life-changing conversation.
然后呢，他们生命在那个对话当中开始改变。
Where Saul then calls him Lord.
就是在那个对话当中，扫罗后来就直接称他为主。
It's a confession.
那是一个他的承认。
It's not the emperor anymore who's my.
他承认是什么？不再是当时罗马帝王为主，而是主为主。
Lord.
他说主啊。
And this.Life-changing conversation.
在这个过程当中，他的生命开始改变。
Literally changed everything for Saul.
也使得扫罗一生完全的翻转。
For him to be able to call Jesus Lord.
你要知道，他能够称基督为主，这是多么的不容易。
Meant he was saying I was wrong and you were right.
意思就是过去的我是错的，我承认你是对的。
I tried to persecute your followers because I thought it was ridiculous.
我过去以为说这些人都在犯傻，所以我去逼迫这些跟随你的门徒。
I thought the emperor was the one with the power.
我原本以为有权力的是凯撒。
But now I recognize you are the one with all the power.
承认你才是最有能力的主。
And all the love.
我要的就是要爱你。
And it changed his life forever.
所以他的生命就此开始完全改变。
The Lord tells him, "You'll go to Damascus, and I'll send somebody to tell you what your next steps are going to be."
主对他说，你尽管去大马士革，我会差派另外一个人告诉你接下来要怎么做。
And here he is, literally blinded. That's what the Lord did to him for a few days.
然后呢，从那之后，保罗扫罗他的眼睛就瞎了几天。
So he couldn't look with his physical eyes.
所以他没有办法再用他的肉眼去看见。
He had to start seeing with spiritual sight what was happening in his world.
他必须开始用他属灵的眼睛去察觉周围正在发生一切事。
And the Lord talked to Ananias.
而主就告诉亚拿尼亚。
A good man.
是一个非常好的人。
A believer.
是一个信徒。
Someone the Lord trusted.
是主所信任的人。
And he said, Ananias, you need to go to Damascus.
他说：“亚拿尼亚，我要你去大马士革。
You need to go to a particular house.
你必须去到那个家中。
There's a man there called Saul.
那里有一个人叫扫罗。
You will know all about him.
你知道关于他的一切事。
He's a believer now.
但是现在他已经是一个信徒。
I need to go, you to go to him.
我需要你去找他。
And tell him what he must do.
然后告诉扫罗他接下来要怎么做。
He must represent me now.
他现在要来代表我了。
And speak about me to the whole non-Jewish world.
然后呢，向所有的犹太人来传讲关于我的事。
But imagine what was going on in the mind and the heart of Ananias.
你要想象当时亚拿尼亚听到这一切的时候，心里作何感想
？Jesus.
他说：“耶稣。
Let me just get this clear.
你让我搞清楚一下。
You want me?
你现在是要我
to go into a room
去到那个人家里
with that man.” Saul.
是那个扫罗叫扫罗吗？
You do remember he's the one that's been killing us.
你没有忘记这个扫罗过去怎么杀我们吧？
Imprisoning us.
然后把我们通关到监牢里。
Persecuting us.
逼迫我们，你有看到吗？
Just said, yeah, absolutely.
主说是的，没错，就是他。
But I love him.
可是我爱他。
And he loves me now.
他也爱我，他现在是爱我的了。
Ananias must have trusted the Lord very, very much.
我相信亚拿尼亚一定是非常的相信。
Because to walk into a room with a killer.
因为他后来他居然跟这个杀人犯同处一室。
Who had hated the church.
这个过去恨恶教会的人。
And now he comes with a message from the Lord.
但他现在带着主的信息来找他。
But look how powerful these words are.
但你看这个话语是多么的有能力。
Ananias walks into the room.
亚拿尼亚进到这个房间。
And he says the first two words.
他讲的头几个字是。
Brother Saul.
他说，我的兄弟扫罗。
Brother Saul.
他说，扫罗弟兄。
If Saul didn't hear anything else, he would have definitely have heard brother Saul.
别的什么他都没有听到，但只要听到扫罗弟兄这几个字就够了。
Because straight away somebody's come into his world.
因为那就表示亚拿尼亚完全视他为自己人，然后呢，让他知道亚拿尼亚是爱他，完全的接纳他这几个字。
And an opportunity to belong.
也因此给他一个机会，让他可以归属在这个里面。
To the family of God.
归属在神的家中。
Brother.
他是说扫罗弟兄。
There's some steps that we have to take if we're going to belong.
如果我们渴望归属，我们必须有一些事要做。
See, some people, some kids are in school groups.
你知道有的时候在学校的团体里。
Have you ever do you do this in Taiwan when you pick two captains?
就是你会选两队队长有没有
？To play a sports game.
如果比方说两队要竞赛，你们要选队长，对不对
？First captain said, "I pick you."
然后呢，继续讲说，哎，我选你。
And the other one said, "Well, I pick you."
然后另外说，哎，我选你。
You.
你就是队长开始选人。
And you're in this line of school boys.
然后呢，大家就是开始排队在等着被选。
Or school girls.
就是或者是男生也好，女生也好。
And the number of people around you is getting less.
就发现说旁边人越来越少，越来越少，但自己就是还没被选到。
And if you're the last one, your whole world has just disintegrated.
基本上你的世界就在那天瓦解了。
Because we just want to be on the team.
因为你真的很渴望能够归属在其中一队。我们都想要被想要。
We want to be valued.
我们都想要被看重。
If people come into a church and all they see are little groups of people talking together,
那如果你想象一个人进到教会里面，发现大家都是小团体，自己小圈圈在讲话。
And you walk past,
然后你就经过旁边。
And you think, well, I'll just keep on walking.
然后就不要看到我，不要看到我。
Because they all know each other.
因为他们已经都彼此认识。
I don't know anybody.
我谁都不认识。
So I'll just keep walking.
我就继续走，继续走。
I'll stand in the corner.
都越角落越好。
And pretend I know what I'm doing.
假装我也知道我在干嘛，就是你知道，到处看。
And just wait for somebody to move, and then you know where they're moving to.
然后呢，就发现到说，哎，别人去到哪，你就赶快跟上。
It's actually a very sad situation for us to leave people in.
如果就是是这样的情形的话，其实是非常难过的，就是没有办法让人融入你们。
We need to have a team of people serving Jesus on the street, in the foyer, in the lounge room, and in the entrance before anyone even gets to church.
我们必须有一些人是在街道上面，在他们还没进到教会里面，就为了耶稣去服侍这群人。
Because it's important to help people to feel that they can belong.
因为很重要的是，我们希望帮助人能够在这里找到那份归属感。
Now belonging happens firstly through being accepted.
到底要怎么找到归属感？首先，他需要自己知道自己是被接纳的。
My father told me for my whole life that he was the only child.
你知道我的父亲一生都告诉我他是家里的独子。
But when I was 40 years of age, he told me that he had 8 siblings.
可是我是到了40岁的时候，他才告诉我真相，说他其实还有8个弟兄姐妹。
When I was 40 years of age,
你要想象我已经长到40岁了，我才听到这个真相。
When he was a young boy,
当他还年轻的时候
，his mother died giving birth.
他的母亲在最后一次的生产过世。
And so the father comes back to the house.
所以当爸爸回到家里
，with a brand new baby，
带着新生儿回来
，and 8 other children，
然后还有其他8个孩子。
He's now got 9 children.
所以他总共有9个孩子。
My father was the middle one.
我的父亲是中间的那一个。
And the father could not cope.
他的父亲也没有办法面对这样的状况。
And he got drunk.
然后他就让自己喝醉。
And got drunk again.
然后呢，不断的酗酒。
And realized he could not do this.
并且认知到说他做不了这件事。
One day walked out of the door, closed the door, left, and never came back.
所以有一天他是直接出了门以后就再也没有回来过。
And the authorities again had to find homes for these children.
后来呢，是社会局去安排这些孩子的去
处。And they put them in twos.
然后他们都让他们尽量两个人一起被领养。
Two children to be adopted by one family, two by another.
其中一个家人领养其中2个孩子。
But the one in the middle.
但是呢，中间的那个孩子
didn't have a sibling to go with.
没有其他的兄弟姐妹跟他一起。
And he was adopted by the Dixons.
然后他就被一个叫 Dixon 的家庭收养。
And he's telling me this when I'm 40 years
old. 然后呢，我是到了40岁才从我爸爸口中听到这个事实。
And he lost his mother.
所以那天他失去他母亲。
He lost his father.
爸爸也走了。
He lost 8 siblings.
其他8个弟兄姐妹也都不见了。
Some of them he never saw them again.
有一些人他们是一生之后再也没有见面过。
But the amazing thing is this.
可是你知道我觉得很特别、很棒的是。
I didn't know any of that.
我其实这一切我都不晓得。
But I knew his parents, as granddad, grandfather, and grandmother Dixon.
对我来说，收养他的父母亲，也就是我的祖父母，我就是他们为亲生祖父母。
And they had a son.
他们还有另外一个孩子。
My dad was the second son.
所以我的父亲其实是他们第二个孩子。
So I grew up with an uncle.
所以我长大的时候是有个叔叔在我身边。
A grandfather and a grandmother.
然后我有祖父，我有祖母。
And I was 40 years of age.
然后呢，到了40岁的时候，
they're my grandparents.
原来我一直以为的祖父母不是亲生的祖父母。
But as soon as my father told me,
可是你知道我爸爸一跟我讲完，我就想到
，I thought, why have I never thought about this before?
我说。其实这件事情是有迹可循，我怎么从来没有发现过？
Like、
因为你们长得根本祖父母都不像，我爸爸跟祖父母长得都不像。
Like、
他跟我的叔叔长得也一点都不像。
How stupid am I?
我想说，我怎么会这么蠢呢、啊、
？The reason why I never even had any doubt.
可是你要知道，我为什么一生从来没有怀疑过这件事
？Is because those two elderly people they loved my son exactly the same, my father the same as their son.
我的祖父母从我父亲还小的时候就如同爱亲生儿子一样爱着。所以他们接纳了我的爸爸，他的弟兄接纳了他。
And when my parents had the amazing blessing of me being a child,
所以当我的祖父母有我这个孙子这么的棒出现在我们的家
里的时候 accepted me as well. 我的祖父母就也完全视我为己。 Acceptance enables you to feel like you completely belong. 就是这样子的接纳使我完全的觉得我归属在这个家中。 It was a healthy adoption. 我说这是一个非常健康的一个过程。 Full of love. 是充满了爱的过程。 Full of acceptance. 也充满了完全的接纳。 But the acceptance has to be both ways. 可是你要知道接纳它是一个双向的事。 And my father embraced their love so much. 是我的父亲也完全接纳了他们给他的爱。He didn't even want to tell the story of what happened before. 甚至不想要讲说，其实他是被领养的。He just wanted to live life being loved by this parent. 他只知道说，我的一生是被我的父母所爱的。The Bible tells us that with Saul, 圣经里面讲到扫罗 verse 28 of chapter 9, it says that he after that he was accepted as one of them. 使徒行传的九章二十八节这里说，使徒被接纳，扫罗被接纳成为门徒后。Saul was eventually accepted by all the believers. 他终于被所有的门徒们、所有信徒给接纳。Saul was not a good man. 你知道扫罗原本不是个好人。You wouldn't want to sit next to him. 你绝对不会想要坐他旁边的。You wouldn't want to anger him. 说你也不想要惹他生气。But something changed in him. 可是他里面发生，他生命发生一个改变。You see, many of us feel that we need to be better people before we come to church. 很多的时候，我们会以为说，来到教会之前，我们必须先成为一个好人。Some of us think, well, The church wouldn't even know the things that I've said. 就是因为他们可能会知道我过去说过什么话。The things that I have done. 或者他们可能会查到我做过什么事。I don't feel clean enough to come to church. 所以我会觉得来到教会，我觉得我这个人不够干净啊。I will never belong there. 我没有一个好的过去，我不属于这个地方。But the reality is. 可是你要知道事实是什么。You don't have to come.And clean yourself before you come. 你不需要在来之前让自己先成为一个清洁无瑕疵的人。And Jesus does all the cleaning. 你只需要照着你的本相来，让耶稣为你洗净。And all the lifting up. 让他来帮助你，让他来举起你。And all the encouraging. 让他来提升你跟鼓励。Jesus can give you a new start. 耶稣会让你有个全新的开始。只要你愿意回应。And no matter how hard you try, you'll never be able to do it. 你知道，不论你再怎么努力，你都没有办法靠自己办到的。But with Jesus in your heart. 但只要耶稣进到你的心里，进到你的生命当中。And in your decision making. 进到你做一切的决定里，并在你的灵里。You will find that He can change your life. 你就发现他能够使你的生命完全翻转。When we lived in Spain for 10 years. 你知道我们之前有住在西班牙十年。And we planted churches. 我们在那里建造教会。In villages and towns and cities. 然后呢，去到许许多不同的城市村庄。And you can imagine Joyce, Chinese, Malaysian, and a blonde-haired Englishman in Spain. 你可以想象 Joyce， 他是一个华人的脸孔，跟着一个英国人。God has a great sense of humor. 就是在西班牙，我觉得神真的非常的幽默。But they were incredible years. 可是那几年对我们来说非常的不可思议。We planted churches. 我们在那里建造教会。We got heroin addicts became believers. 然后呢，有原本是毒瘾的，然后成为一个信徒。I didn't even know how to help a heroin addict. 那你知道我甚至不知道怎么去帮助这些有毒瘾的人。So I went away to a drug rehabilitation center for 2 weeks to learn. 所以我有去那些就是帮助毒瘾犯就是戒毒的中心。We had a very interesting church. 去学习。那我们的教会也很有趣。It was a beautiful church. 那是一个很棒的教会。We had professionals in the church. 然后呢，在我们教会里面有很多的不同的职业。They were sitting next to former prostitutes. 然后呢，那他们甚至有一些是就是贩淫的。We had business people. 然后呢，也有就是生意人。Who were in the belong group. 然后呢，他们在他们的小组里。That was run by somebody who stole from their house a few years before. 这些呢，就是生意人他们的组长可能是过去偷过他们家东西的人。所以那个组成真的是非常的特别。A mix of everything. 因为你可以说它是所有集大成在那间教会里面。The good.不论是好的 是坏的 we even had the ugly. 我们就是很丑陋的都一起聚集在那里 But everyone was beautiful to us. 可是呢每一个在我们的眼中都是最美的那是很棒的一个经历 Some people we would pick up out of a gutter. 那你知道有人可能是直接就是从贫民区里面出来 keep helping them. 然后又回去帮助他们 Late at night on streets. 就可能晚上在街上 helping them to get home. 去帮助他们能够找到住的地方 And months later, 然后几个月后 they too become believers. 他们也成了信徒 then become leaders in the church 然后呢成为我们的教会的领袖 exactly what happened right here. 然后就好像是我们刚看到这个故事里面所说的 the hope.The hope, no? You need to be excellent at accepting people. 弟兄姐妹，你们必须要成为接纳人的专家。You need to be the most accepting church that Taiwan has ever seen. 我说在 The Hope， 我们一定要成为最能够接纳不同的人来到我们当中的教会。It should make no difference to you the social status of a person. 我说不论这个人他是什么样的社会阶级，来到这里都是一样的。You treat everybody with equality. 我们只用一个平等的心来看待每一个人。You honor the poor. 然后呢，不论是贫穷，我们尊荣。
他。有钱的人，我们自己也尊荣。
Just the same，
是完全一样的尊荣。
You give up your seat for anybody，
是没有差别。我们愿意让位给他们，我们愿意去服侍每一个人。
You buy coffee and food for anybody，
买咖啡或者是请他们喝什么东西。
And then the name not only of Jesus。But the Jesus representatives, his church, get the name that they deserve.
我说不光是耶稣的名要在这里被高举，我们代表耶稣，只要我们好好代表出来，在这里大家也要知道的 Hope 这个名字。
But it's not only accepted.
可是我说不光是接纳而已。
You'll see in the story of Saul, there was an advocate.
你知道在扫罗他的生命里面，还有另外一个人是大力拥护他。
Ananias accepted him first.
当亚拿尼亚先接纳了他以后
，Brother Saul,
他就说：“哎，我扫罗弟兄啊。
”But Barnabas was an advocate for him.
巴拿巴是一个愿意大力拥护他、为他说话的人。
Read chapter 9 and verse 27.
我们要来读第九章《使徒行传》九章二十七节，这里是怎么说的呢？《使徒行传》第九章二十七节，只有巴拿巴接待他，带他去见使徒，把他怎样在路上看见主，主向他说话，和他怎样在大马士革奉耶稣的名放胆讲道，都讲了出来。
I love those first few words there.
那你知道我很喜欢这里他所说的。
Barnabas took him.
他说巴拿巴带了他。
And brought him to the apostles.
然后呢，带他到这些使徒面前。
Why?
说为什么
Because Barnabas was wise.
因为你知道巴拿巴是个聪明人。
He's thinking, well, I know the truth about Saul now.
他说我现在知道保罗真是个怎么样的人。他已经是个信徒了。
He's now defending the faith instead of persecuting the faith.
还传讲耶稣道，没有再去逼迫弟兄姐妹。
Ananias knows about it.
亚拿尼亚也知道。
Many believers know that he's changed.
那所以很多其他信徒可能看到了，也知道这件事。
I'm not sure the apostles even know that this has happened.
我不确定这些使徒们、这些领袖们知不知道。
But I need to introduce him to somebody else that can help him.
但我要介绍他给那些能够帮助他的人来认识。
And so he takes his new friend Saul.
所以他就带着他这个新朋友扫罗。
And he travels to where the apostles are.
带他去到使徒们的面前。
And he said.Peter, James, John, I'm sure you're concerned the way that many others have been.
他说哦，彼得是约翰跟雅各，我知道你们好像其他的人一样会对这个人有担忧。
Because this is my friend Saul.
可是你们要知道，这个人就是我的兄弟，我的马吉。
And he's a believer with us.
他是一个跟我们一样的信徒了。
I've seen the change.
我看到他生命的改变。
I've heard him speak.
我听过他怎么讲道。
I just want to introduce you to him.
我只是希望你们今天也可以来认识他。
And it would not have been easy for them either.
那我要说，对这些人来说也不容易。
Because Saul had been so bad.
因为你知道扫罗过去真的太坏了。
But the beautiful thing is that somebody cared enough for him.
可是有一个人在乎他到一个地步。
To keep on introducing him to more people that can help him.
愿意不论的把他介绍给更多人认识，让更多人可以来帮助他。
The hope needs to be a church.
我说 ，The hope 我们要成为这样的教会。
That just doesn't accept people.
我们不光是接纳人来到我们当中。
Bringing people to others to get to know other people.
我们愿意让一个没有人认识的人带到其他人面前来介绍大家给他认识。
People that can help them.
是能够帮助他们的人介绍他们认识。
You know, if at the end of this service,
我说如果今天聚会后
you meet somebody,
你碰到了一个人
I hope you always stop and meet people.
我希望你总是会留步，然后来认识人。
Don't run out at the end of the service.
你不要一结束马上就冲出去。
At the end of the last service,
我说在刚前节里面
when it finished, I went downstairs with George down the lift.
结束聚会结束后，我下到楼下去
and stood around where the coffee is.
然后呢，就在那个咖啡桌旁边
just to see what people do.
就看看大家都在干嘛。
And I nearly got knocked over.
然后我几乎都大家已经快把我挤倒了。
There was a stampede of people.
因为你知道，就是太多人，就是大家走得太快，我差点被撞倒。
They couldn't walk any faster.
就是我发现怎么走得这么快。
If they walked any faster, they would be running.
因为如果再走更快一点，可能就是跑起
来。But I'm asking you to slow down.
可是我真的想说，你们慢一点，慢一点。
And say hi to a few people.
你可不可以跟一些人打个招呼，好不好
？And shake some hands.
然后跟一个人握握手，可以吗
？When you see a face you don't know.
就你看到一个不认识的人的脸
That's your Holy Spirit invitation to say, hey, how are you?
你看到一个不认识的脸，你要想起是圣灵在邀约你去跟他打个招呼。
And we stood there for a few minutes.
我们就站在那里几分钟的时间。
Some people waved at us.
有一些人跟我们挥个手打招呼。
So we waved back.
然后我就挥回去。
And every opportunity I had.
每一次的机会。
I stood in the way of people so they couldn't get past me.
就是我都挡在人的面前，不让他们离开。
How are you, sir?
我说
how are you doing?
你今天好吗？你今天好吗？
And we had some of the most beautiful conversations.
哎，我们就有一些很美好的谈话。
One man here for the first time this morning.
我刚有碰到一个第一次来到我们当中的人。
He's a wine importer, so he's a very important man.
你知道认识他很重要，因为他是专门进红酒的。
May the Lord bless him.
就是真的是祝福了我们整个世界啊。
May he be generous in his offering.
愿他在奉献上当当的慷慨。
And there was a lady there for the second time, beautiful young lady.
然后呢，也碰到一个姐妹，非常的年轻美丽的姐妹。
And I said, Did you enjoy it this morning?
然后就说你今天早上还聚会还好吗
？And the man said, Yeah, I really did love this morning.
然后他旁边一个弟兄说，我真的很喜欢今天早上聚会。
I like asking questions.
我很喜欢问人问题的。
I said, Why?
我说你为什么觉得很棒？
And he said, "Well, I felt very welcome."
他说我来到这里，我觉得很被欢迎。
And by the end of the message,
然后呢，在聚会讲到结束
，I realized like I'd learned so many things.
我发现我真的学到好多东西。
I was very challenged about how to do life.
所以也挑战了我知道说我生命接下来该怎么做。
And I will be here every week.
我接下来每一个礼拜我都要回到这里。
And the lady with the second time.
然后呢？他旁边那个女生是第二次来，我也问他，你还享受今天的聚会吗
？Yes, I did.
他说我超享受，谢谢你牧师。
How many times have you been? This is my second.
我说你来几次啊？这是我第二次来。
Did you like it?
那你还喜欢这里吗
？The people are wonderful.
我说这里的人都好棒。
The music is so good.
我觉得他们的音乐都好棒。
And I learned so much from what was said in the church.
每一次在台上讲到都好帮助我。
I just want to keep coming.
所以我真的很想每一次每一次再回来。
You see.If I didn't go down the lift,
如果今天我等一下搭电梯下去
with an intention,
是带着一个想法是
of stopping,
我要停下来
and trying to say hello to a few people,
尝试跟一些人打个招呼
I would never have shaken the hand of the man for the first time.
我如果没有这样去做的话，我不会跟一个第一次来我们当中人握手
or the lady for the second time,
或是第二次来到我们当中那个姐妹握手
I would never have been able to ask what is important to people who visit for the first time.
如果我没有这样去做，我也不会有机会问他们说，哎，那今天的聚会到底可以怎么样的帮助到你
It was the people.
那重点都是这些人
It was the welcome.
也就是你们，就是我们受欢迎
It was alive worship.
是我们的敬拜
It was what was said from the church.
然后呢，或者是我们台上的讲道
To help them see things differently in life.
帮助他们能够在生命里面有个不同的看见
You will never have those opportunities to help people if you rush out.
如果你就是聚会完以后马上就离开的话，你从来都不会有这个机会知道原来这些东西怎么影响了他们
Slow down.
所以你要让你的脚步慢一
点。The kitchen will still be open in the restaurant you're going to.
就算是定位晚一点，还有十分钟的保留吗？你不用赶那么快。
Five minutes later than you would have gone
there. 就是晚一点也没有关系的。
If you talk to somebody and you find out where they're from.
那如果你跟一个人聊，你发现他们是来自哪里
？Where are you from? I live near the airport.
然后就说，哎，你住哪里？我住的离机场很近。
I know somebody who lives near the airport. They must live near you.
我有认识住在桃园离机场近的人。
And because you're an advocate.
然后呢，因为你还记得吗？你是大力拥护的人。
I need to introduce you to.
我说，哎，我一定要介绍你给那个谁谁谁认识。
They travel across all the time.
然后呢，就尝试让他们可以彼此认识。他们可能就会发现。
Here's my details.
他说，哎，你看，我留个资料。
Change details.
然后呢，就留资料。
What do you do? Oh, I'm a school teacher.
他说，哎，你做什么？我是学校老师。
You're a school teacher.
我是老师哦。
You need to meet Pastor Peggy.
那你一定要认识 Peggy 啊。
She's a school teacher.
她是也是老师。
She understands school teachers.
她知道学校老师。
When you talk, you will understand one another.
对，你们两个聊的话，一定会聊得超开的。
And you have children as well.
那你有孩子是不是
？You will definitely need to talk.
哇，那你们一定要更要多聊。
And encourage one another.
然后呢，彼此鼓励一下。
What? You're from Singapore.
他说你是新加坡来。
We have people from Singapore.
你知道我们的牧者里面有一个新加坡人，那你一定要认识我们当中的新加坡人。
Oh, you're a single young lady.
哇，你还是单身，是不是姐妹单身
？You need to meet Pastor John, our worship leader.
那你要认识我们敬拜主领 Pastor John 吗？
He's in the corner with his on his knees.
有点害羞，在角落里面跪着祷告。
Lord, help me.
主啊，救我。
This church exists for the people who are not in it.
我说教会的存在就是为了还没有来我们当中人存在。
I'm going to say that again.
我要再讲一次。
This church exists for the people who are not yet in it.
我们是为了那些还没有来到我们的当中的人而存在的。
There are already church options in Taipei.
我说在台北可能已经有很多其他的教会。
There's some great churches in Taipei.
有很多很棒的教会在台北。
We don't need to do another church exactly the same.
我们不需要再有另外一间完全一模一样的教会。
But to do a church that thinks about the new person.
可是我们要成为一个一直为新朋友着想的教会。
Welcomes the new person.
想想怎么去欢迎那些新朋友来到我们当中。
Explains things to new people.
然后呢，解释那些他们可能会不懂的东西。
Makes people feel welcome.
让他们觉得在这里是被欢迎的。
Everybody who's got a terrible past is welcome.
让 每一个人知道，不论过去如何，在这里
是被欢迎。Wherever you are from, you are welcome.
来自哪里，你在这里是被欢迎。
You've had a bad church experience in the past.
你过去有去过教会，然后经验不好，是不是？没关系，在这里是一个全新的宴，在这里是被欢迎的。
So that's why it might be a little bit different than some people have experienced before.
我相信可能有一些人过去的经历不同。
But if it helps us help people,
可是帮助我们能够去帮助其他人。
Then let's do church in a way that helps them.
我们的经历都能够帮助我们去帮助到其他人，让他们可以在这里有一个不同的经历。
But not only do we as a church have to do things to help people belong.
可是不光是教会，我们应该这样的去帮助人在这里找到归属感。
Those of you who are here this morning and you're not sure whether you belong or not.
我刚刚讲的是教会弟兄姊妹该做，但如果你今天来我们当中，你也不确定自己是不是归属这个地方。
There are two things in this story that you need to do as well.
我们刚讲的这个故事里面，还不确定弟兄姊妹，你也有事情要来做。
These are the two things that Saul had to do.
是扫罗他在这个故事里面他必须要去做的。
So don't just wait for everybody else to come and serve you and relate to you. You go and talk to them.
所以我们当中的新朋友，你可能也不要一直等着说，哎，那谁要来找我讲话？可不可以你也去跨出一步去找人跟他聊聊
？So if you're new,
如果你是新朋友
，don't race off at the end.
你也不要一聚会以后就马上往外冲。
At least say hello to one or two or five.
可不可以至少跟一到两个人打个招呼
？Stop for a free coffee.
然后呢，就是停下脚步，然后跟他一起喝个咖啡。
It's very good coffee.
这咖啡真的很棒，一分钱一分货的咖啡。
Stay for the coffee that is free. I like free.
我很喜欢不用钱的咖啡，我们底下都有提供。
Invite somebody for lunch.
然后呢，邀请人一起吃个午饭嘛。
Because church experience doesn't finish when we say amen.
因为呢，教会不是在我们讲完阿门以后就完全没了。
For some people, that's when it begins.
对某一些人来说，是在讲完聚会离开这里以后开始教会。
That new friendship that they begin.
可能是一个新的友谊关系。
That first conversation they have.
或者是你开始的第一次对话。
The first time. The first time.For somebody that they feel welcomed.
可能是有些人第一次在我们当中感觉到被欢迎。
Maybe everybody this week at home, it's been tough.
可能有些人他在家里面面临到很困难的处境。
In the workplace, it can be very tough.
或者是在工作的场合上面，他面临到很不顺心的事。
Coming to church can be the first time in a whole week that somebody said, "You are so welcome."
可能是第一次当他在教会里面，他
Thank you
这个礼拜终于第一次又感觉到自己是被欢迎。
And if they don't remember anything the rest of the morning, that's the one thing that Jesus wanted them to know.
所以就算今天早上讲的任何东西他不记得了，可是只要那个欢迎，就会让他觉得这一切有价值。
That's why the street and the foyer and everywhere else and the lounge is so important.
所以你要知道，不论你是在哪里，在外面的哪个地方，你欢迎人都是非常的重要的。
So Saul decided he needed to do something as well.
所以保罗也决定他必须要做些什么。
Verse 26, it says, when he came to Jerusalem, he tried.To join the disciples.
第二十六节那里讲到说，当他来到耶路撒冷的时候，他是尝试要加入门徒。
He knew they were afraid of him.
可是他们却害怕他。
He knew they didn't believe in him yet. They didn't know.
他们还没有办法完全相信扫罗。
But there was something in his heart.
可是在他的心里。
That I am going to show some intention.
他也决定我要让他们知道我的心意是什么。
I'm willing to take some steps and go and meet these believers.
我愿意跨出我的舒适圈去跟这些门徒们相遇。
And if you're going to ever belong in a new community or a family.
如果你渴望归属在一个群体或一个大家庭当中，
you have to take some steps.
你也必须要跨出那一步。
Hopefully the church takes 9 steps, but you still need to take 1.
希望你跨出一步，然后其他人跨出了9步来到你面前。
Just talk to some people.
但是你必须跨出那一步，可能就跟人讲个话，跟人碰个面。
I'll tell you why it's a wise thing to do.
我告诉你为什么这么做很重要。
Because we could preach things off here that we don't live out.
因为你知道，有时候我们可能台上讲得很开心，但是却没有活出来。
Somebody can use a microphone and say things, and their life doesn't back it up.
有人可能在台上说的一回事，但其实生活里面却完全另外一回事。所以你这么做，其实也好像是去
see if their life backs up the words that they say.
是一个明察暗访，去看看说他们是不是真的有活出他们台上讲的道。
Because I'll be honest with you now.
因为我告诉你，我说老实话。
We are all imperfect.
我们也都是不完美的人。
But we have given our lives to the Lord Jesus Christ.
当我们献上自己的一生，就是为了耶稣。
And we're asking the Holy Spirit's help every day to live the way that honors Jesus.
我们也是每一天都求圣灵来帮助我们能够活出耶稣基督的道。
And I won't ask you to be generous unless I am generous.
那如果我自己没有先慷慨，我也没有办法要求你要慷慨。
I won't ask you to love people unless I love people.
除非我先去爱人，不然我怎么有条件来叫你耶稣？
I won't even ask you to go out to the foyers and onto the street to welcome and say goodbye to people unless I do it first.
除非我自己先去这样做，不然我也没有权利要求你要先出去跟人打招呼，或是跟人说再见。
So get to know people in the church.
所以我说你要学习去认识在教会里面已经在教会的这些人。
Not only listen to some of the leaders, but go and say hello and thank you and ask them a question every now and again.
可能不是只是听他们在台上讲到，可能有机会来问问他问题，然后跟他打个招呼。
Ask people about the leaders.
然后呢，甚至问其他弟兄姊妹说：“哎，你觉得你们教会的牧者怎么样？”
Let's see if they're legitimate human beings.
然后看看说，哎，他们是不是也是跟他讲的一样这么好？
Or not.
如果他们是不是真的是信徒？
If their life backs up the words that they preach.
看看他们的生命是不是有活出他们所在传讲的东西？
I know what the answer is because I found out.
我知道这个答案是什么，我已经知道答案，因为我一直跟他们相处。过去这四年，我不断与他们相处。但你自己需要发现。
And so Saul did something about it.
所以扫罗他也做了一件事。
Got to know some believers.
他也尝试去认识这些信徒。
But I'll tell you what the main thing is.
那我告诉你最重要的。
He got to know Jesus for himself.
他自己认识了耶稣。
On the road to Damascus.
在大马士革路上。
When he met Jesus.
当他遇见耶稣。
He could not believe that Jesus would forgive him.
他没有办法想象耶稣居然原谅了他。
Saul, why do you persecute me?
他说：“扫罗，扫罗，你为什么逼迫我？”
And straight away, Saul would have looked into the eyes of Jesus and think he knows everything that I've been doing.
那一刻，我相信扫罗看着耶稣眼睛，他知道耶稣已经知道一切。
Oh Jesus, I got it so wrong.
主啊，我真的错的离谱了。
And his life is changed on that one road experience.
就在那个路上的那个经历里面，他的生命。
From that moment forward, he was so full of gratitude.
从那之后，他的生命就完全的改变。
He was so full of thankfulness to Jesus.
他的生命里面对耶稣是充满了极大的感恩。
His heart was changed.
他的心改变了。
He no longer was filled with hatred and anger.
不再是带着憎恨跟愤怒。
But his heart was filled with humility now.
而是完全的谦卑下。
His ambitions were changed.
他的野心也不再一样。
He was no longer trying to climb the ladder of the Roman Empire.
不再是尝试在罗马帝国里面往高位爬。
He was now happy to be on his knees before the King of Kings.
愿意在这位万王之王面前跪下他的双膝。
His mindset was changed.
他的心意也完全的不一样。
He no longer believed in himself and his own power.
他不再是信靠自己的能力跟相信自己。
He no longer believed that the emperor had all the power.
也不再是相信是罗马的帝国君王有一切权力。
His faith changed.
他的信念也改变。
No longer in an empire.
他不再是相信这个罗马帝国，也不再是相信人所立的君王。他的信心是完全建立在耶稣身上。
That's why his behaviors changed.
这是为什么他的行为也随之改变。
Persecuting other people.
他不再是去逼迫其他基督徒。
Blaming other people.
怪罪其他的人。
Criticizing other people.
或是批评其他的人。
Punishing other people.
惩罚其他的人。
He was just so grateful for what Jesus Christ had done in his life.
他只是单单的感谢耶稣在他生命里面成就的一切。
He was amazed by the grace.
他被神的恩慈所吸引。
That Jesus had showed him.
是耶稣所让他看见的。
I wonder if you know him.
我不知道你认不认识这位神。
The Bible tells us that it doesn't matter whether you're Jew or Greek or anything in between.
圣经讲到说，不论是外邦人、犹太人。
Doesn't matter whether you're male or female.
不论你是男或是女。
Bible tells us that we are all one in Christ Jesus.
圣经说，在基督里，我们都成为一了。
The thing that changes our life isn't that the church is good.
不是教会好不好能够决定我们能够改变。
Although that is of supreme importance.
虽然说教会好也是非常重要。
But ultimately, it's Jesus Christ who can help you even more than we as a church can.
可是最终能够使你生命改变的不是教会，而是耶稣。
I'm going to pray a prayer now.
我现在来做一个祷告。
And I'm going to.Give you the opportunity of praying these words along with me.
我想要给你这个机会，跟我一起来开口做这个祷告。
Because I believe in this auditorium today.
因为我相信今天在我们当中。
In this nightclub.
就在这个夜店里。
That there are men and women and young people.
可能有一些人，不论是男是女。
That you're still working out where you belong.
你好像还在寻找一个可归属之处。
You're still working out in your heart what is going on.
你心里面还在摸索这一切到底是怎么回事。
You're still not sure of so many things.
你还有很多事情是你不确定。
But you've heard something this morning.
可是今天你听见了一些东西。
That is like a seed.
好像是一个种子一样。
That's gone into your heart.
现在能够进到你的心。
It's not fully developed and not fully grown yet.
它还没有完全的发芽。
But you know it's there.
可是你知道这个种子已经栽种到你的心。
It's almost as if the Lord has spoken to you.
我相信这是主今天在对你说话。
And I'm going to pray a brave prayer.
而我要来带你做一个祷告。
And I'll tell you what it's going to include.
那我告诉你他会祷告什么。
Because these are the words that if you would give me the honor that you can pray to.
因为我相信这些话，只要你相信你尊重他，你也可以做这样的祷告。
I'm going to pray a prayer on your behalf.
我要来为你做这个祷告。
And you take these words as your word.
但是你就仿佛这个祷告是
由你口中发出。Jesus Christ.
然后你邀请耶稣。
To reveal Himself to you.
向你显明他自己。
That you would know for yourself that He's real.
让你自己可以知道他是一个真正的神。
That He loves you.
他爱你。
Accepts you.
他已经接纳了你。
On the balconies.
无论是坐二楼。
In the back row.
或是坐在后座。
And in every row in between.
无论你坐在哪里。
It's a prayer that will invite Him to become the Lord of your life.
这个祷告是邀请他进到你的生命，成为你生命的主。
You don't need all the A to Z.
你不需要，好像一切就完全得到一切的解答。
You need to make a first step of faith.
你只需要先踏出这个信心。
And allow Jesus to do everything.
让耶稣来为你成就那一切。
So I'm going to ask you all to close your eyes.
所以我先邀请你把眼睛闭上。
That will give dignity in this room to everybody else.
我们每一个人都把眼睛闭上，
让其他人。I'm going to ask you to center your thinking upon Jesus Christ.
我让你把心思定睛在耶稣身上。
And if you're brave, pray these words with me.
如果你可以的话。邀请你开口跟我一起祷告。
When I said the whole room praise the words, and then nobody's embarrassed by hearing their own voice.
那我也邀请你，不论有没有做过这个，我们每一个人都开口，这样不会有人觉得尴尬。
Are you ready?
你预备好了吗
？Let's pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Jesus Christ.
耶稣基督。
I come to you this day.
我今天来到你面前。
Because I need you in my life.
因为我需要你在我的生命里。
I ask you.To reveal yourself to me.
求你向我显明你自己。
To show me that you are real.
让我看见你是真实的。
So I can experience your love.
好叫我可以经历你的爱。
And your forgiveness.
经历你的饶恕。
So forgive me now.
求你原谅我。
Of all of my past.
原谅我的过去。
Give me a new start.
让我有一个全新的开始。
A brand new beginning.
一个崭新的开始。
Change my heart.
改变我的心。
Change my mind and my thinking.
求你改变我的心思意念。
Be the Lord of my life.
成为我生命的主。
From this day forward.
从今天开始。
Jesus.
耶稣。
You are my Lord.
你是我的主。
You are my Savior.
你是我的救主。
Holy Spirit.
圣灵。
You are my guide.
你是我的引导者。
From this day onwards.
从今天开始。
I am a believer.
我是一个信徒。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.
I suggest in this room we stand to our feet.
我们从座位站起来。
We celebrate with all of those people who make that decision.
来欢庆，我们一起跟其他弟兄姐妹来欢庆。
Let's worship God together before Peter comes. God bless you. We love you.
Bye.
兄姐妹都能够来接纳人，就像你是怎么样接纳我们，都可以帮助我们来爱人，就像你是怎么样爱我们，帮助我们来饶恕人，就像你是怎么样来先饶恕我们每一个人的罪。主，我感谢赞美你，这是我们的呼求，这是我们的祷告，帮助我们每个人可以在这段生命的旅程当中更好的来向你，更好的来爱，更好的来爱人，更多的来向你。感谢赞美你，这是我们的祷告，以上祷告是奉主耶稣宝贵的名求， Amen Amen。哇，谢谢 Pastor Steve 帮我们带来这么棒的信息，我真的是鼓励大家，就是不只是像 Pastor Steve 讲的，就是我们更多的来接纳彼此，更多甚至你可以来邀请那些你不熟的人到你的家，你煮饭给他们吃，我们来为每一个人来更多走一里路，是没有人要求我们的，但是是我们可以来选择，我们要用这样的爱来爱他们，用这样的方式来接纳他们。我在去年的时候，我上完比隆课，我真的不知道为什么，我那一天就有两个新朋友，我就直接带他们来我家吃饭，我就说来我家看电影，然后叫他们来我家吃饭，然后我也不知道为什么我会突然做这个选择，可是从那时候开始，我们变成非常要好的朋友。有一个现在在台上打鼓，也是我的小组员，然后有一个他现在要加入 CH1， 要来当我们的 intern， 要当全职的intern 实习生，所以你永远不知道，你只是做一个简单的邀请说，嘿，你等下有没有事，要不要来我家吃个饭，或是我们去 hang out 一下，你永远不知道会发生什么事情，你永远不知道你简单的一个要求会去改变这些人的生命。所以我们真的鼓励大家，我们可以再多走一里路。最后我们有一个报告事项，是我们这个礼拜二的7月30号7:30，很简单，就记730，是我的 passion 敬拜之夜。如果你跟我一样喜欢敬拜的话，欢迎大家把时间留下来，我们要沉浸在90分钟，不停的一直来敬拜神，不停的来神的同在。所以呢，谁留下来，但是因为人会很多，所以鼓励大家7点就要先赶快进来占位置。OK， 7点占位置，在 The Hope Office。好，我们今天的聚会即将要结束，谢谢大家来到这边，我今天真的很开心看到你们。See you on Passion, see you on Tuesday。祝大家有个美好的几天。收看，我希望你有得到非常多的收获。我邀请你一起来订阅我们的频道，并且分享这个影片在你的社群媒体上面给你的朋友，也许你的朋友真的很需要这样子的一个祝福。那我也鼓励你一起来报名服事团队，一起加入我们，一起来建造这个家。我们下个礼拜见哦。